children, this is another episode of Generation Next, and I'm sure you all are excited to watch this episode. Now, today on Generation Next, in the first segment, we're going to be having a puppet show. Yay! Yippee! Puppet show! And I'm sure you all are going to enjoy this. Sit back at home, children, and enjoy.
Good everyone, how are you all today? My name is Small Boy, and I'm here with my friends. We are here to give you some special songs. And the first one is titled Champions. My friends are Big Mouth.
Hello, everyone.
Chukwezima.
Hello, everyone.
Mr. Bear.
Hello, everyone.
And the Word One.
Hello, everyone.
We are here to give you some special songs, and the first one is titled Champion. As you listen, may you be blessed.
Back to us.
is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Exalt my life, tail within, called on Christ. Fail again, all my life I've dwelled in sin, causing strife. My flare was dim, was lost in life. My prayer was then, to floss some ice, inhale revenge, to ball like Mike. V12 or Benz, turn off the lights and nail your friends, but you fall from heights. When the ledge is thin, when you're called to fight, but you're scared to win. When they've marked the price, when you're head for 10, and you're calling Christ, cause you dread the grim. And it's all good night, if you pledge with him. You done lost your sight, better tread and swim. Some sharks will bite, shred your limbs, gemstones for life, spread the hymns.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up, yeah. To break every chain. Break every chain, break every chain.
Break every chain.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Father God, take the wheel, touch my heart, by grace I'm healed. Fill me up, bless my soul, clean me out, make me whole. Heal my mind, break the chains, spare my life, stop the rain. The clouds, sing your doves, shine your light, sing your love, make me feel, touch my hands, you're my shield, touch my fans, anoint my head, direct my feet, correct my path, I bless the meek, I bless my craft, I bless the weak, I bless the staff, I bless the chief, I bless your laughs, I bless your grief, I'm blessed to have, I'm blessed to be, I'm blessed in wrath, I'm blessed in peace, blessed to grab, bless the speech, I'm blessed to grab, I'm blessed to reach, in Jesus' name, the chains release, We only live a moment, cause nothing lasts forever. Receive it now and own it, it's either now or never. But never seem forever, but ever seem to never. Come when you're in the moment, you wish would last forever. You realize alone this, bro, that you're walking on it. Not what you really want, but how bad you really want it. Hey, y'all, we finally grown up, I thought that's what we wanted. So we can do the grown up, whenever that we want it. And smoke on marijuana, and live within the moment. Just say nobody own us, yeah, less than don't condone it. Cause who can right or wrong us, the mirror's my opponent. It's either now we grown up, that we don't even want it. God is my everything that I ever could ever want it. The top cause I dare to dream, I could rock when I'm dead and gone. If you rockin' this bread, your wings keep them blocking. I ever long because life is not guaranteed. And tomorrow may never come, I got some love for that. He sent his only begotten son that whoever believe on perish. But life should be carried on to eternity and forever. I know that he won't be long, I'll be dropping these broken chains till I'm standing before the throne.
Woo! I hear the chains falling.
I hear the chains falling. The chains of doubt.
I hear the chains
of insecurity.
Falling.
The chains of depression.
The chains of falling.
The chains of stress.
I hear the
chains of hate.
Chains
the chains
falling.
Of envy. The chains
you
of jealousy.
Hear it.
The chains
I
of
hear
lies.
The chains.
The chains of cancer.
The chains
of alcohol.
Enjoyed the puppet show. I did. It was so much fun. All right, kids, it's time for Bible story time with Auntie Tracy. Are you ready to listen to today's story? I'm ready. I'm prepared. Hope you all are too. We'll go on a short break and we'll be right back, kids. Bye. Hello, children! How you all doing? Welcome to another episode of Bible Storytime with Auntie Tracy. And I'm sure you all are excited to watch this episode. Now, let's do a brief recap of what we did the last time. Remember, on our last episode, I told you a story about Moses and how he ran for his life. And do you remember why he ran away? He ran away because he killed an Egyptian. What led to it? Okay, let's do this. Remember, I told you that an Egyptian was beating up an Israelite and Moses was really infuriated. He got angry because remember that Moses is an Israelite, not an Egyptian. And so for that reason, Moses killed the Egyptian and buried him while leaving the Israelites to go scot-free. And so he didn't know that people were actually watching him. He thought nobody saw him. And so the next day, remember I told you that two Israelites were fighting. And, you know, being an Israelite, he wanted to be the peacemaker in quotes. And he tried separating them, saying, my brothers, don't fight. Fighting is not good. Don't fight. Forgetting that he killed an Egyptian the previous day. And so one of the Israelites looked at him and said, oh, so you want to kill us the same way you killed your brother yesterday? And he became really scared and he was like, oh, they found out. And that kind of thing. And that was what made Moses run. He ran for his life because he was scared that he would face the punishment for his crime. And so, fast forward. Today's story, we're going to be talking about Moses. Yes. What happens to Moses after he ran away from Egypt? Today, we'll find out in our story. How many of you are ready to listen to the story? I'm sure you all are ready. Now, listen attentively because I will ask questions at the end of the story. All right? Very good. The title for our story for today is The Burning Bush. Whoa, the burning bush. Have you seen a bush burning? Do you know what it looks like? How many of you have seen fire? Probably a bush burning and fire coming out of it. I'm sure you must have watched movies, you must have watched cartoons and seen such. Yes, the bush burning. But what led to the bush burning? We'll find out shortly. And so, Moses, remember I told you that Moses moved or ran away to the land of Midian to stay with his uncle. His uncle was called what? What's the name of his uncle? Jethro. That's very good. If you got that right, thumbs up. His name of his uncle was Jethro. And so in the land of Midian one day, Moses wanted to take a stroll. He was probably tired of staying indoors and probably the heat was so much and he wanted to just get fresh air. And he decided to take a stroll. And so he was walking, you know, just going, walking, saying hi to his friends. Hi everybody. And just saying hi to everybody and walking. Then he walked till he got to a mountain called Horeb. Yeah, he walked to a mountain called Horeb. And so when he got to Mount Horeb, he saw something really strange. And he was shocked, but he had to move closer to know what exactly it was. And when he moved closer, he saw a bush burning. A bush was actually on fire, but it wasn't burning. Do you understand what that means? I'll give you a scenario. Imagine a paper. You can see the flames on the paper, but the paper is not burning. The fire is not having effect on the paper. That was exactly how it was. The bush was on fire. Everybody could see it, but it wasn't burning. And so Moses looked like, what? Why is this happening? What exactly is this? And so as he tried to get closer, he heard a voice. Moses, Moses, take off your shoes, for this is a holy ground. And he turned. Oh, that must be God speaking. And he looked and found out that God was speaking. Through the burning bush. And so he removed his shoes and bowed his head. And so God told him, Moses, Moses, I have seen the pain of my people, the Israelites, in the land of Egypt. And I want to send you to save them and to give them freedom from Pharaoh. And Moses looked up and said, me? Moses?
How will I do it? How do I go? Who do I talk to? And how will they release? How will they be released from Israel? And how will they be released from Egypt? Is it possible that this will ever happen? Why me? And God told him, do not worry. I am the one sending you to Egypt to free my people. And he asked him, so what if Pharaoh asks and tells me, who exactly sent you? What do I tell him? And God answered and told him, you tell him that the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, and the God of Abraham sent you to them. And Moses looked again and said, okay, but still, even if I tell them that, they may not release the people of Israel. They may not listen to me. And God told him, of course. Remember that Moses was always holding a stick. He had a stick with him. All right? Look at the picture on the screen and you see a stick he was holding. And so Moses held the stick and God instructed him, take that stick in your hand and strike it on the floor. And I'm sure Moses must have wondered, what exactly is God trying to tell me? Why am I taking a stick and throwing it on the floor? Well, he said, anyway, I'll do it. And he took the stick in his hand and struck it on the floor. And guess what happened, children? Do you want to know what happened? That stick turned into a snake. Wow. I'm sure that must be your reaction. Like, wow. That happened, children. The stick turned into a snake. That must be a miracle. Wow. God performed a miracle. And so the snake was crawling and crawling on the floor. And Moses must have been really wowed and shocked. And God told him, pick up the stick. And once he picked up the snake, it turned back to his stick. Wow. Have you ever seen something like this happen before? Children, have you seen miracles? What is a miracle? And have you seen any miracle? Have you seen, read of stories of Jesus performing miracles? I'm sure you have. Now, this was a major miracle that happened before Moses. And God showed him another sign. Do you know what God told him to do next? God told him, Moses, dip your hand into your robe. And so Moses took his right hand and dipped it into his robe he was putting on. And when he brought it out, his hand was white, like very white, like a person who had leprosy. A person who has leprosy, most times the hands are always white and the skin, it's a disease of the skin. And so Moses' hands were white. And when he was instructed to dip it back into his robe, it became normal. Wow, that was another miracle. Another miracle before Moses. And so God also instructed him to do other things, to show him different miracles and different things he would show Pharaoh when he gets to Egypt. And he did exactly as he was told. Now, children, it is very important that you obey instructions. It is very important that you do what? Obey instructions. Imagine Moses had argued with God and told him, no, it can't happen. Why would you tell me to? No, I don't believe all of these things. I don't believe it will happen. Imagine he had argued with God. Then none of these things would have manifested. But Moses believed God. What did I say, children? Moses believed God. Can you repeat it again? Moses believed God. And so all of these things happened. And Moses, of course, he said, yes, God, let your will be done. And so that was it. The experience of Moses at the burning bush on the mountain of Horeb. On the mountain called what? Horeb. And so that experience alone, with all he had in Midian, Moses went back to his uncle Jethro and told him, dear uncle, God has called me on an assignment. I've been given an assignment to leave the land of Midian to save the people of Israel from the hands of Pharaoh. And so, uncle, I must leave. I'm sure Jethro must have felt very sad letting go of Moses, but he had to obey the voice of God. Moses had to obey what? The voice of God. And so Moses packed all his bags, packed his suitcase, all his fine clothes. Moses packed his shoes and everything he had and left the land of Midian to the land of Egypt. He left the land of Midian to the land of Egypt because he wanted to obey the voice of God. Children, as we can see in this story, the importance of obedience. Moses did not argue with God. He didn't tell God, hey God, you don't know what you're saying. No, he didn't tell God that. But he obeyed the voice of God. God gave him an instruction and he listened. And so Moses packed all he had and went with his wife called Zipporah. Do you remember Zipporah? I told you in the last episode. He took his wife Zipporah, his children and everything he had and went to the land of Egypt, just as God had instructed. So the question is, children, what exactly happened after that? Do you think Moses would get killed for obeying God's instruction? Do you think Pharaoh will kill him? What will happen to Moses? That's a very sure question. I know you want the answers to that question. And if you do, join us in our next episode. I will tell you the story of how God saved the people of Israelites from the hand of Pharaoh. All right, in our next story, we'll hear all of that. And guess what time it is? It's question time. Yay! It's that time when I ask you questions about what you've learned from the story. Now, my first question is, which mountain did Moses go to? Which mountain did Moses go to experience God speaking to him through the burning bush? Which mountain? What's the name of the mountain? Have you gotten the answer? The mountain is called Mountain Horeb. What did I say? Mountain Horeb. If you got that right, thumbs up. Good one, kids. Very good. My second question is, what was the instruction God gave to Moses on the Mount Horeb? What instruction did God give Moses? Do you want to know? Do you have the answer for me? All right. God told Moses to go to Egypt and show Pharaoh some of the signs and miracles to free the Israelites from him. To free the Israelites from Pharaoh. Did you get that right? Good. You are Bible scholars. Very good. Very, very good. You are Bible scholars. Thumbs up. My next question is, did Moses disobey God? True or false? Moses disobeyed God. True or false? It's false. Moses did not disobey God. Moses obeyed God. He left the land of Midian to the land of Egypt, just as God had instructed. Did you get that right? Did you, children? If you did, thumbs up. Very good one. Clap for yourselves. Yay! Good one, good one. And finally, the last question. What are some of the moral lessons you've learned from this story? Can you mention some? Say it out loud. Oh, yeah. Very good. Very, very good. Now we'll mention some of the moral lessons that we learned from this story. One, it is good to obey God's voice. It is good to do what? Obey God's voice, just like Moses did. And what are some other things we learned from it? God is a miracle-working God. Oh, yeah, he is. He is. He is. Are you sure? Yes, God is. He performed so many miracles in front of Moses. And that was what gave Moses the confidence to go back to Egypt. So, yes, God is a miracle-working God. And finally, we should learn to obey God. All right? God gives instruction. Obey. Obey the will of God. It is very, very important. And so that's all we can take today on Bible Storytime with Auntie Tracy. And I'm so glad that you all have learned one or two things from today's story. And I'm sure you will go back home to your schools and wherever you find yourself and make an impact. God bless you, kids. Take good care of yourselves. Have an awesome week ahead. And bye for now. Hi, kids. Hope you all enjoyed the last segment, Bible Storytime with Auntie Tracy. And I'm sure you all learned from the story told today. Now, this is the third segment. And today on the third segment, we'll be teaching an activity song, an action song. Are you ready to learn the song we have for you today? All right, come along with me and sing along. Are you ready? Now, with your right hand first, let's do this together. Come on. I put my right hand in, I put my right hand out. In, out, shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. Come on again. I put my right hand in, I put my right hand out. In, out, shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. Sing, oh, my Jesus loves me. Hoo, hoo, hoo. Oh, my Jesus loves me. No, my Jesus loves me. And that's what it's all about. Are you ready to do the left hand? Have you learned the song now? All right, let's do the left hand together. One, two, go. I put my left hand in. I put my left hand out. In, out, shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. I put my left hand in, I put my left hand out. In, out, shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. And oh, my Jesus loves me. No, my Jesus loves me. No, my Jesus loves me. And that's what it's all about. Hooray! All right, kids. Now we're going to do that with our whole body, putting it in and out. Are you ready, kids? All right, let's go. I put my whole self in. I put my whole self out. In, out, and shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. I put my whole self in, I put my whole self out. In, out, shake it all around. I know my Jesus loves me and I turn myself around. That's what it's all about. Hooray! Yay! All right, kids, hope you all enjoy the action song. Next week, we'll be singing more action songs. All right, kids, if you have questions and for feedback, you can reach us on the email on your screen right now. The email showing on your screen. And you can also reach us on the WhatsApp number right now showing on your screen. Do not forget, we'll love, 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 love to hear from you all. And so till we come here next time, bye, children, and God bless you all.